to our yoga class today. So today I wanted to dedicate the sequence to yoga for an open heart. So today we're going to be working a lot with a mudra. So mudra is a hand gesture that you'll see that we talk a lot about in yoga and in Buddhist traditions and Hindu traditions. But mudra means seal. So like if you think of a seal on an envelope or a stamp. So the seal is a hand gesture. You know, there's many, many different ones. It can just be an okay sign. It can be very complicated mudras. And they all have the purpose of kind of channeling energy and the flow of prana, activating certain parts of our brain for a specific goal. So today the mudra that we're going to be working with very consistently throughout the practice, I'm so excited to incorporate it in so many ways, is the mudra of Vajra Pradama. So it's very simple, it's just interlacing the fingers. That's Vajra Pradama, which translates to unshakable faith. So we're gonna find a seat, and I'll talk a little bit more about the mudra. We'll find a seat by sitting on top of our block. So if you have a block, great. If you don't, just grab a blanket, or you can, a pillow, anything that you need, or fold even up your mat, roll it into a tube to start. So we'll start by sitting on a block. We're going to kind of draw our knees together and have our feet kind of out to the side a little bit. So we're kind of sitting in between the fanning of our feet. So here we're gonna, you know, open up the thighs, the quadriceps, create a little bit more space in the knees, just to bring in our practice. And we'll start with that Vajra Pradama Mudra, interlacing our fingers and placing them over our hearts. So this mudra of unshakable faith is just a beautiful celebration of faith. It can be in the divine, or it can be also faith in ourselves. I love that there's another translation in Sanskrit. In Sanskrit there's the word shraddha, and shraddha means it means faith, and it also means self-confidence. So there really is this dual translation of faith in the world and others and the universe and divine forces and faith in anything outside of yourself. But it's also faith and trust in yourself. And I think that's a beautiful intention for today's practice on opening our heart. So here we're sitting in Virasana and Hero's Pose, and we're going to close our eyes and lift our hearts up with every breath. You'll feel the chest rise on the inhales. With your eyes fluttered closed, you'll focus even more attention on the inhale and the exhale. Maybe you can feel your heartbeat gently. Maybe you just notice everything slowing down. Everything's starting to soften. The heart chakra is called anahata. It's the spinning, beautiful wheel of energy in our heart center. And it translates in Sanskrit, anahata, to unstruck, an unstruck sound that resonates everywhere, within everything. So gently we'll flutter our eyes open, release our hands, take our block or blanket or anything out from underneath us. I'm just going to toss mine to the side. I'm not going to use it at all in the practice anymore, but you're welcome to keep yours close at hand. Okay, so let's begin by coming and just gently, we're going to extend one leg behind us and then switch the other leg. Just get a little blood flow back to the legs so you might feel they're a little tight and sticky. We're going to do it one more time on each side. And then push yourself up into a plank. Both legs extended.
strength as we lift our hearts off the mat and out to the world. Notice that if you push more into the forearms, you gain more height. Feel yourself becoming taller. Now take the right hand and flip the palm upwards. Tuck that palm and that hand underneath the other elbow and slide it all the way through, dropping the head to the mat and extending that right arm or the left arm with a tented finger in front of you. I'm just gonna wake up our shoulders right now. Stress your palms on the mat really close to the chest. We're going to push up into a cobra, maybe a little higher than normal. Keep the elbows locked in nice and tight. Again, shine the heart. Lower the head, drop the mat, and fold back into a gentle child's pose. We just activated the spine, so now we get a nice, gentle relaxation in child pose for a couple breaths. Again, notice the shift in your energy. Everything's starting to slow down and soften. From here, draw the hands back. Draw your knees together. All the way up on your knees, inhaling the arms up, extend the hands again in Vajrayana mudra behind the head, lean back, and as you exhale, let the hands sweep forward and interlace, launching over the head, folding the weight of the body back towards the heels. Inhale, repeat it by coming up, Vajrayana, hands behind the head. Release. Last time, inhaling, behind the head, arch back, look up, and as you exhale, sweep the hands down, grab them behind the shoulders, and launch them over the head. Inhale, sit up, spread the knees just a little bit apart. And place your fingertips behind you. We're going to send the hips skyward. Inhale. Gentle back bend. As you exhale, come forward into tabletop. But we're just going to take the right leg forward now and come into Anjaneyasana. So now again, we're going to take our hands behind. drop the right hand to the mat, untuck the toes, and come up into a spinal or a lunge twist. You're welcome to stay here if this feels great. We're going to enter rock star again by sweeping the front foot behind us, launching the hips up. Over the body, and then either cobra or upward dog, and back to downward dog. Enjoy a few breaths here, and then mellowing out, finding your center, pressing the heart towards the legs. Tension in the neck, no tension in the face or the jaw. Maybe put a smile on your face. Remember, this is about self-confidence, self-trust, as much as it is about faith in others. So now take the right leg up into the sky. Take it forward in between the hands. Seal the back foot and come up into warrior one. Interlace the hands and send them up. Release the hands, go behind the back, humble warrior again. Interlocking the hands, launching the shoulders overhead. Release the bind, come into warrior two. And go back to the peaceful warrior and the wall. Get up on the asana. Back to the mat, left hand next to the foot. Twist and lunge again. Go for our rock star again, sweeping the front foot behind. Launch your hips up. You got it. It feels so good. Come back to plank. Lower the body. Inhale, upward dog or cobra. Back to downward dog. Left foot into the air. Exhale, draw the foot through the hands. Seal the back leg. Come up into warrior one, interlacing the hands. Gazing up, really straightening the spine. Keeping the energy forward. Exhale, release the hands down, wrap them again behind your back, launch them overhead, humble warrior. So much about, I think, about faith in ourselves and self-confidence. now from here, I'm going to replace my hand. It's actually the left hand that'll go forward. I'm going to slide my left hand underneath my front foot, seal my back foot, and twist open. It's pretty challenging here, creating a little shelf out of the tricep. Try to hold it just for a few seconds. Place the right hand on the mat, pop the back foot off, and extend the left hand to the side too. So you're almost like having these little flying wings underneath the top foot. Sorry. I've heard it called flying Ganesh before. It's a beautiful and challenging pose. I think that really challenges the strength of my back leg, the flexibility in my shoulders. So now let's release. Coming all the way down, chaturanga, wash it away. Upward dog, cleansing breaths. Forward fold, back bend. Bouncing up. So now we'll take the left foot forward, tent the fingers, and warrior three, so pop up the back foot. Underneath, tented fingers are, well, one arm is underneath the front foot, the other's to the side, flying the mesh. Both hands to the mat, meet in plank, chaturanga, or lower the body all the way, upward dog or cobra. And back, this time though, into child's. You deserve a little rest after that challenge. Roll your forehead from side to side. Feel how much you're taking care of yourself right now. While we open our hearts to others, I hope you also use this as an opportunity to open your heart to yourself. Okay, guys, one last challenge. We're going to draw this time. We're going to come up into almost a tabletop position. Drawing the right leg in between the hands. Let's pop the back knee up again. Tent our fingers. Warrior three. Pop the back leg up. And this time we'll do that mudra, Vajrapranama, over our hearts. Warrior three. Now draw the drop the right hand to the mat, put the left hand on the hip, and we're tilting our body in the half moon. The heart stays open, the chest is not collapsing. If you want to try full moon, chapasana, reach back for your back foot, hook onto it. Really open the heart then, really open the side body. Release. Draw into plank. Go down chaturanga, quick wash. Up your dog. And down your dog. Table. Again, left now. Left side goes forward, left leg. Pop open, pop up your back knee. And come into warrior three, popping the back leg. Whenever you're ready, Vajrapadama, unshakable faith, over your heart. Drop the left hand to the mat. Open the side body, half moon. You really feel a tilt, right? And your hips start to occur as you're opening the whole side body to the side of the room. It's okay, I just fell a little. It's okay if you do too. It's part of the journey. And now go back for chapasana if you want to try. Grabbing a hold of the back foot. Opening the heart. Drop back, coming into plank, downward dog, upward dog, oh sorry, I said that wrong, chaturanga to downward dog up. So now drop to your knees, slide your feet out to the side, draw your legs in front of you, and just do a nice, beautiful forward fold. So go ahead, reach for your heels, bend your knees, or reach for your arches or your toes. Bend your knees as much as you need. Feel your heart lower to your own thighs. And then work on straightening the legs from there. Feel the gratitude coursing through you, for your strength, for your ability to stretch, to grow and expand and challenge. There's so much gratitude for the faith you can have in your own ability to try new things, embrace a little fear, and at the end, take care of yourself. Let go. We're going to take the left leg off the mat, bending the right leg, placing it against the inner thigh. I'm going to reach for the outer edge of my extended foot with my left hand, launching my right hand behind me like in a wing. I'll then draw it overhead with the intention of drawing it nearer to that foot. choice whenever we are able to locate or find things that maybe you were holding us back. We can breathe into your courage opening. So now go ahead, release. Extend both legs. Let's give a little shake again. Bend the knees. Drop them from side to side. Space and place. And now from here, bend the knees, plant the feet on the mat about the distance of the hips. We're going to come up into bridge pose by lifting our hips off the mat. I'm going to interlace my fingers again beneath my body. I'm underneath the glute area, launching my chest, my belly, my hips. Even higher up, trying to keep my knees though in alignment. It's almost as if I'm launching them straight in front of me. Don't let them dive out to the sides. If you want to challenge, come up onto your toes, send your body even higher, and then lower the body to the mat. If you'd like to do that for a second round, I invite you to go into bridge pose again. But if you want to try for chakrasana, for wheel pose, you can celebrate that opportunity, and we'll do it together. So let's plant our hands behind us. If you notice, my fingertips are facing my own shoulders. So to do that again, you raise your hands up, bend at the elbows, and plant your hands next to your head. So you're welcome to watch me do it too. You can do bridge pose, watch, and then try it on your own. You can do whatever you need. So from here, in chakrasana, my knees are to be about the distance of my hips. Plant the feet. Give a full exhale. And on the inhale, launch. Press your feet very firmly into the mat. Launch your hips up. And lift up. You can plant your head on the mat if you need it before pushing all the way up into a full wheel. It's a beautiful heart opener. Really encouraging and challenging. If you want, move the feet in. Play around, shift the weight. Feel where the body's resisting and where it's loving it. And when you're ready, move the feet out. Lower, tucking the chin towards the chest, lowering the body back down. Before moving your hands to the side, pushing your body up. And now a really gentle forward fold. It's just after such a dramatic back bend, you need to counterbalance that. Forward fold. Back bends are challenging and they are a little hard on our bodies. Also beautiful and also just such a great expression of having an open heart and faith, because there is a lot of trust you have when you're unable to look in front of you, when you're in such a vulnerable position of being kind of contorted in an unnatural. And natural, I mean, in terms of we don't do it in our daily life. Pose, it involves trust. both legs go out straight. Give them a little wiggle if you need. And you wave the feet. Now the last asana before Shavasana is the universal spinal twist. So I'm bending my right knee, connecting my left hand to it, and drawing it across my body. Extending the opposite arm like an airplane wing, and gazing out over that extended arm. The spinal twist at the very end are to help us kind of reset our spine. As we've done so many forward and backward and side bend and all these different things, we want to make sure everything has an opportunity to kind of be set straight. So come back to center, switch sides, right hand connects to left leg, draws across the body, left arm extends. Try to see if you can keep your shoulders on the mat. Kind of pop up just a little bit, especially the extended arm. Just intentionally try to keep the chest lower, the back of the heart. Find your spot for Shavasana. Adjust anything you want. Maybe take the mudra, Vajra Pradama, behind the head, lengthening the neck away from the shoulders. Maybe you want to do Vajra Pradama, the mudra on your heart for our Shavasana today. Maybe instead of on the heart, you want it to be on the belly. Wherever you feel like you need a little more faith, unshakable faith, right? Wherever you feel like you need to grow and build a kind of sense of self-confidence and self-trust, you're welcome to place your hands in this mudra over a certain part of your body, whether it's the belly, the heart, maybe even the throat, but that might not be so relaxing. You need more expression and trust in your own voice. Maybe on your third eye, you feel like you need a little bit more intuition. You need to listen to that inner voice. You need to call it forth. Whenever you want, go ahead and release the hands and let them fall to the mat. Keep them where they are. It's totally up to you. We're going to enjoy just a few moments. Relaxation, rejuvenation, and restoration. Why not? All three. So just gently follow your inhales and exhales. Wiggle the fingers, wiggle the toes, wake the body up. Give yourself a